Hi everyone, Michael here. So here we have a Duesenberg Fullerton CC, very cool guitar. Duesenberg have risen to great heights over the past 10, 12, 15 years with players such as Joe Walsh, one of my favorite guitar players, Vince Gill, Robbie Macintosh, Ron Wood, the list is endless. I recently encountered one of these when I recently met Andy Powell from Wishbone Ash. He had not particularly a Fullerton, but he had a Duesenberg as on stage with him, and he uses one of those as well. So there's plenty of players using these guitars, and I can see why. Very, very vibey indeed. I don't have any guitar. I have a lot of guitars, but I don't have any guitars that sort of do what this thing does. That's why I sort of did a little bit of a rockabilly thing in the performance, because it's just crying out for that sort of old school sort of playing. But you can get some very modern sort of attitudes out of it. Let's just take a look at it. It's a very Art Deco design, going from the headstock. Lovely, look at that lovely offset design at the top there. And if I flip it over, it looks like it's got locking machine heads, which is very cool indeed. So although it looks retro, there's some very modern things going on here. We got a maple. I think this is all maple, this the back of the neck, but the fretboard is Indian rosewood. And we've got some plecked fretwork on the neck. Plecked means it's been finished by a machine that gets, you know, just gets rid of any indiscrepancies that you might get by hand. It's very, very highly sort of machined, in terms of the frets are very even, there's no buzz anywhere, there's no dead spots. And that's what a plec machine does. And it also rounds off the frets. The frets are lovely, it feels great. The neck is quite substantial, but I like that. Big necks usually sound better on guitars. It's very comfortable in the hand. As you can see, it's this vintage sort of cream color. The whole body, the back and the sides and all the back, and there's a center block in the middle, is all maple. So this center block runs down the middle, and it's got hollow chambers at the side, very, very 335, and it's almost the same width as a 335. It's quite weighty, but not uncomfortable weighty, but a lot of that weight is coming from this very cool, very retro trem, which actually works quite well. It's tuning. I mean, it's very, very smooth. You can move it with your little finger. It almost looks like a Bigsby, but I just feel there's a lot more going on with Duesenberg. They've refined and sort of improved a lot of old designs, and it's just very vibey. It works great, you know. Pickup wise, we've got this is a single coil, and this is a humbucker, their own design. I would say the single coil is sort of very in the P90 register. It's got a nice sort of flutiness to it. And if I just flick it to the middle there, let me pick up a. It's a master tone and master volume, but this is both pickups together. When you play near the bridge there. Here's the humbucker. This is a humbucker, their own design humbucker. Need some of that. See, none of my other guitars do that. It's a very Art Deco design, isn't it? It's very, very cool looking. The fact that they've sprayed it a solid color means that they're not wasting wood. If it's a spruce top, maple back, maple, these wood is now, you know, good wood is a commodity and they can't afford to waste wood. So probably with the maple that's got some nice figuring on it, they will probably stain it and you'll be able to see the grain. It'll be a flame or a bird's eye maple or something. But if it's just a plain piece of maple, then it sounds just as good and you could spray it a solid color. It's a standard volume and tone, so you can, you know, if I'm playing on the treble pickup, you can turn the tone all the way down. So turn it back up. And what does that sound like on the neck? Tone all the way down. It back up. So it works as well, you know, and they've got a lovely feel to the pots. It's very substantial in terms of it's smooth, but feels like it's, you know, very, very well made. So all in all, it's a very, very vibey guitar. Look at the nice, look at the detailing on the strap lock there. It's very cool indeed. It's just nice, and the more you look at the guitar, the more you see some really cool details. Love the scratch plate as well, look at that. It's very 50s sort of Americana, isn't it? Love it. This will do a lot of things that maybe your average guitar won't. It's got that certain sort of, I don't know, that certain retro sound, but with modern sounds included. Comes with these feel like fairly substantial strings, maybe 10s or maybe even 11s. What I also like is as you back the guitar down, the pickups, they clean up quite nicely, you know. So it has a real sound to it. And back to that humbucker. The string spacing isn't quite as wide as what I'm used to. I've only just picked this guitar up, but I'm soon getting used to it. The actual sort of width of the neck is slightly slimmer than what I might normally play, but very, very comfortable. The action is great, straight out of the very nice case. It was in tune. The case on it is just, you know, it's lovely. Not a cheap guitar, but you are paying for very, very good quality here. And it's a real statement guitar. It makes an impression. If as soon as you turn up a gig with this, you're going to make an impression. What I would be curious about is at stage volumes, because it's got the hollow chambers, sometimes at high gain stage volumes, you're going to get that thing that, you know, hollow body guitars can do, where they can start vibrating. So it's not really designed for the real high gain stuff, although it might cater for it. I don't know. I've got a 335. Sometimes it does it, sometimes it doesn't do it. Depends how much gain, where you're standing in relation to the amp. But this is more for those probably more retro sounds. The pickups are voiced for that sort of thing, I think, but they do sound good. They sound like they can handle any sort of modern situation. Love the tremolo. It's fantastic. Look at that. And it looks very, very well made. It stays in tune as well. Unlike most Bigsby's I've tried, this actually stays in tune. And actually, you've got quite a nice upward pull as well. Just works great. It feels great and works great. It's higher than it normally would be if you actually look at how high it is. I can deal with that because I can, you know, pick with my thumb and it's just, it's all there. But, you know, for the odd, it'd be great. And I've got to do this noise again because I like it. Cool. So this is the Fullerton CC. Absolutely fantastic guitar. I'm very impressed. This is really the first one I've actually tried. And it's made an impression on me, so I may look at dig one out for myself. Actually, very cool. The Duesenberg Fullerton CC.